Hello friends, in this video we will discuss Newton's first law of motion. In the last video we finished vector series. Please make sure you watch all parts of vectors, part 1 to part 12. Sir Isaac Newton was an English scientist. He was born on 4th January 1643 in United Kingdom. In 1667 he developed three laws of motion that explain movement of objects and its relation with the applied force. These three laws of motion work in all situations of motions like linear motion, circular motion, rotational motion. In all the kinds of motion these three laws work properly and still holds true today. So what is first law of motion? I have divided this first law in two parts. First part says if an object is at rest, it will remain at rest until it is acted upon by an unbalanced force. So suppose this is a soccer ball sitting at the ground and there is no force acting on this soccer ball. So it will remain at rest until we apply a force or we push this soccer ball to make it move. If we don't push or pull or apply any force on this soccer ball, this soccer ball will remain at rest as it is now. The next thing is, what is unbalanced force? Suppose this is a box and it is at rest, that means it's not moving. Then you apply a force or you push this box towards right, then box will start moving towards right. This is a single force which is applied by you, so this kind of force is called as unbalanced force. And this unbalanced force will make the object move. But if a person is pushing the box from the left and then there is another person who is pushing the box from the right and both are applying the same force in the opposite direction. So there are two forces with same amount but in the opposite direction. So these forces are balancing each other and there is no net force on the box. So these pair of forces are called as balanced force. And the balanced force will not make this box move. So box will remain at rest. First, when there is no force acting on the object. And second, when there is a balanced force acting on the object. In both cases, there is no change in the state of motion of the object. So if an object is at rest, it will remain at rest until it is acted upon by an unbalanced force like this here. And the second part of the first law says, if an object is moving uniformly, it will remain in uniform motion until it is acted upon by an unbalanced force. Suppose there is a soccer ball, it is at rest initially and then you kick the ball. So ball starts moving with some speed v. So Newton's first law says, box will keep moving until someone apply a force from the opposite direction to stop it. Suppose after some time ball is at this position and someone pushes it from the right, that slows down the ball. This force is an unbalanced force and only unbalanced force can change the motion of the ball. Otherwise, ball will keep moving with the same speed. In real life, if a ball is moving with some speed, then it will stop after some time, whether you stop it or not, but it will stop automatically. Why? Actually, there is a force which is called as friction force and it is applied by the ground, like this ground, and this friction force stops the ball. That's why whenever you kick the ball and ball starts moving and after some time it will stop because of the friction force of the surface or the ground. But if you go in space and throw a ball, ball will keep moving uniformly with the same speed and it will not stop because there is no friction force in the space. So you can see the example of first law of motion in the space. Let's summarize the Newton's first law. So an object will not change its state of motion. State of motion means there are two states of motion, like first is at rest and second is moving uniformly. Uniformly means it's not speeding up or not slowing down. It's just moving with the same speed. So this box is currently at rest and it will remain at rest until it is pushed or pulled. The same way, if this ball is moving towards right, it will keep moving towards right with the same speed until it is pushed or pulled to speed up or slow down. Newton's first law is also called as Law of Inertia. Here, inertia is the tendency of the object which resists changes in object's motion. This is the definition of inertia. So, inertia is actually directly proportional to mass. More mass means more inertia. So, a heavier object which has more mass will be hard to change its state of motion. So, a heavier object would have more inertia. Or, you can also say, it's hard to change the state of motion of a heavier object. So, that means we need more force to make a heavier object moving. So, whenever we talk about inertia, it's directly related to the mass of the object. That's why Newton's first law is also called as law of inertia. I hope you understand this topic so far. In the next video, we will discuss Newton's second law of motion. So stay tuned and study more. Don't forget to subscribe, share and likes for daily updates. Thank you.